Hi, this is Mike from Hunter Industries. The purpose of this video is to show you how to properly set up and install a solar sink sensor on an ACC controller. ACC is a versatile controller suitable for the most advanced, large-scale commercial sites. Its adaptable design allows interaction with a variety of accessories, such as the solar sink sensor, making it a very powerful controller. So in this video training, we'll be showing you how the solar sink sensor interacts with the ACC controller. We'll be covering how to check for compatibility between the controller and the sensor, as well as physically install the sensor on the controller. We'll go through all of the solar sink setup selections and show you how to as well enable the solar sink to work with the controller. We'll also cover how to check for communications between the controller itself and the sensor once they're physically connected. And we'll show you how to choose the region and also any future adjustments that you may need to do down the road. We'll be covering configuring the rain and temperature portion of the sensor, and also how to assign the solar sink to the programs that you want it to govern. As well, there'll be a portion where we'll be covering tracking adjustment history, and also we'll show you how to cover the alarms that may have been produced by the sensor itself within the face pack. So whether you use your ACC controller as a conventional system or as a two-wire decoder system, all of the installation and programming processes will be just the same. Solar sink is a sensor that measures sunlight and temperature and uses these factors to determine the correct seasonal adjustment percentage value to send to the controller. The ACC controller will adjust its programmed run times based on updated information received daily from the solar sink. The days to water and the number of start times per day do not change. Only the run times are adjusted up and down depending on the climate conditions. For this reason, it is important that in the beginning you program the controller as you would normally for the hottest month of the year, with the seasonal adjustment set at 100%. The solar sink will then adjust the run times from there. The solar sink sensor also incorporates a rain click sensor and a freeze click sensor to shut off the system immediately in the event of rain or freezing conditions if you choose to use these features. Therefore, it is very important that the sensor is placed in a location where it can receive full direct sunlight as well as rainfall. The solar sink is compatible with all newer ACC controllers. To verify if your controller is compatible, check the master module to make sure it says solar sink compatible. The controller also needs to have a revision number of 5.0 or newer for hardwired solar sinks and 5.01 or newer for wireless solar sinks. You can check all versions at once in the Advanced Features Utility Functions menu. When using an ACC controller, all you need is the sensor itself, be it wireless or hardwired. You don't need the entire solar sink kit. The ACC has all of those programming options built right into the face pack. The solar sink sensor is available in a hardwired version and in a wireless version. The hardwired sensor comes with 40 feet or 12 meters of cable, but can be extended up to 200 feet or 60 meters using 18 gauge or 1 millimeter wire. This cable consists of two wires, one black and one green. The wireless version consists of a sensor and a receiver. The sensor can be installed up to 800 feet away from the receiver, depending on terrain and obstacles. The receiver has a black and green wire that is connected to the ET terminals within the controller. Always verify the sensor and receiver are synced and communicating.
Regardless of the version you have, the black and green wires connect to the controller via the two ET terminal screws, green to green and black to black.
So once the solar sink sensor is physically installed, we'll need to make all of our selections in the face pack of the controller. As mentioned earlier, it is crucial to program the controller with the seasonal adjustment set at 100%, and as if you were programming it during the peak summer watering season. To set up the solar sink sensor, turn the dial to Advanced Features. Using the down arrow button, select ET Functions and press the plus button to access it. Select ET Operation and the display will ask you if you want to use ET. Choose Yes to enable it. press the down arrow button and specify whether you are using a solar sink or an ET sensor in conjunction with IMMS central system. Since we are installing a solar sink sensor, choose solar sink. Go back with the back arrow to the ET functions menu and select solar sink check. This will ensure communication between the sensor and the controller. If the sensor is properly connected, the display will say sensor check OK. Otherwise, it will say sensor check failed. Remember, if using a wireless solar sink, the sensor check only checks the wireless receiver connection to the controller. It cannot check the actual sensor transmitter. Once you verify there is a working connection between the controller and the receiver, go back again and select solar sink setup to program the region. So to choose the region, you should reference the ET tables in the ACC owner's manual or in the SolarSync owner's manual to decide which region best fits you. There are three ways of choosing the region. The first and most reliable method is according to the average ET or evapotranspiration rate for July or whatever the hottest month of the year is in your area. You can usually find this information on the internet. Another method is according to the average temperature for July or whatever the hottest month is. The third method is according to a general description of the area you live in. To change the region, press the plus or the minus button. The water adjustment is a 1 to 10 scale that allows you to fine-tune your system in case it is underwatering or overwatering. Upon installation, it is recommended to leave it at 5 so you can make adjustments from there if needed. So once you install the solar sink, you'll want to monitor the landscape for up to a week or 10 days possibly to ensure that you're getting the right amount of water in the proper areas. If you notice that the seasonal adjustment percentage is too low for the weather condition and that all your landscape areas need a little bit more water, you can increase the water adjustment scale. Likewise, if you feel like the percentage is too high and your landscape may not need as much water, then you need to decrease the water adjustment level. This change will be reflected immediately under the seasonal adjustment. So if you decide that the changes that were made on the water adjustment scale were insufficient, you can simply choose a different region that's more appropriate for your area. If you feel like your entire landscape still needs more water, you may need to decrease the region number. If you need less water, you may need to increase the region number. This may sound contradictory to you, but remember the solar sink recognizes the regions for their expected evapotranspiration rate. Since a low region number, such as a coastal region, expects to see low evapotranspiration rates, when the solar sink detects a certain ET rate, such as 0.15 inches, it may almost be at the top of its range, so it will think that it is very hot for its region and will increase the run times. A high region number, such as a desert region, expects to see high evapotranspiration rates. Therefore, when it reaches the same evapotranspiration rate of 0.15 inches as the coastal region, this rate may barely represent half of the expected rate for this region. So it will think that it is not hot enough and it will reduce the run times down. So the water adjustment scale and the region should only be changed if all of the stations or the entire controller is either too wet or too dry. If you're only dealing with a few individual stations, you can simply increase or decrease the minutes from their original runtime. The latest feature in the ACC Solar Sync combo is called the Solar Sync Delay. This is a great feature which allows you to set a certain amount of days that the solar sync will delay going into action. This is a nice option if you have a brand new landscape and you want a certain watering schedule for the first 2 or 3 weeks or a month to get the plants grown in and established. If you set up your delay, the delay will count down the days automatically for the amount of days that you've chosen, and once the delays have expired or the days are over with, the solar sync will take effect with the existing weather pattern. It's a pretty neat option so you won't have to wait the 3 days to get an average weather reading going like you would on a basic initial install. It'll just step right in step with the weather with what's going on. The other nice part about it is it'll save you a trip going back to the job site once those plants are established to have to go in and put your solar sink online. This feature will do it for you. When you select the solar sink delay feature, you can specify the number of days to water without solar sink adjustment.
In the case of the ACC, this is 1 to 250 days. Enter the delay with the plus or minus button. You can also specify the percentage to use during the delay period. The controller will still water, but it'll water at the percentage you've chosen here in this screen, and it'll time out once the delay has ended. The added benefit is that the sensor will be logging ET the whole time, just not adjusting any programs yet. The day the delay times out, SolarSync will be right where it should be for the climate conditions, and will set the specified programs to the correct amount. In addition to the 1 to 250 day delay, you can also set the delay to always. The sensor will track ET, but the controller will not enable SolarSync adjustment until it is manually set to the 0 day setting, meaning the delay is over and the SolarSync will now adjust. While the controller is in SolarSync delay mode, the main display will show the delay and the percentage you have set it to use in the meantime. It is important to note that the delay will not affect the rain and freeze sensors if you are using them for shutdown purposes. They are still in effect, only the SolarSync adjustment is affected by the delay setting. As you might expect, the delay settings are tracked in the controller log at the data history dial position, and so is the expiration of the delay. The SolarSync delay feature is present in FacePack versions 5.10.006 or newer. If your FacePack does not have that feature, feel free to go to our website and you can flash update your existing FacePack for free at hunterindustries.com. As mentioned in the beginning, the SolarSync sensor can be used for rain or freeze shutdowns, but these functions will need to be configured in the FacePack. When you turn the dial to set sensor operation, you will be able to see any regular click type sensors that are connected through the sensor terminals in the wiring compartment or through a sensor decoder. Whenever a click type sensor is connected to a sensor terminal, the corresponding sensor input on the display will appear as inactive unless the sensor has been tripped and showing active. Any sensor terminals that are not in use will appear as active and can be used for other click sensors. The controller is equipped with four click sensor inputs, which are normally used for rain, freeze, and other sensor inputs. However, with SolarSync, we can assign the rain and freeze inputs from SolarSync to these sensors in the controller settings without connecting any additional wires. Here's how. Turn the dial away from set sensor operation, as this is a hidden feature. Press and hold the blue information button while turning back the dial to set sensor operation. Release the blue information button upon arrival. This will access the sensor operation menu. Here, you will be able to assign the location for each of the sensor inputs. Press the plus or minus button to select the sensor input you'd like to assign to SolarSync Rain. Then press the down arrow to highlight the location. Use the plus or minus button to change from controller to SolarSync Rain or SolarSync Temp. Even though the SolarSync sensor is connected through the ET sensor connections and not through any of the four sensor connections, you can assign two sensor inputs to control the rain and temperature functions of the SolarSync sensor. If you want to use both functions, assign SolarSync Rain to one sensor input and SolarSync Temp to another. They cannot share the same sensor. In the ACC, this will still leave you with two more sensor terminals for other purposes, to which you can still wire sensors directly. Once a particular sensor input is configured as SolarSync Rain or SolarSync Temperature, you can then make changes to the sensor type. If we go back to normal sensor operation menu, we will notice that the sensor inputs 1 and 2 became inactive as they have been configured as SolarSync Rain and SolarSync Temperature in the sensor configuration menu. Now we should be able to choose whether we want these two functions to be off or to suspend or pause an irrigation program in the event of rain or freezing conditions. Notice this is done by program. Therefore, you need to determine whether you want the rain and temperature factors to affect each of your programs. If you want both functions to take effect, you need to configure both to suspend.
Otherwise, you can choose to use only one of them and turn the other one off, or turn both of them off on certain programs. This is all done by program. For example, if you have some zones that do not want to get water when it rains, then you might want to program these zones in a separate program and turn the rain function off so that sensor doesn't shut down irrigation even if it rains. Again, setting the sensor operation is done per program, so make sure you tell each of the programs that you'll be using how to react to rain and temperature. So once you've configured the solar sink sensor, it's time to make a decision as to which programs seasonal adjustment will be governed by the solar sink. This is done at the set station runtime's position. When you are in this dial position, besides programming the runtimes, you can also specify whether you want this program to adjust the runtimes based on the seasonal adjustment you manually make, or to delegate this adjustment to the solar sink sensor. To make changes, you need to press the right arrow button to go up to seasonal adjustment. If you want solar sync to make automatic adjustments to the percentage, then you need to choose solar sync. On the other hand, if you have specialized irrigation, such as newly planted zones, and you have assigned them to a separate program because you prefer to be in charge of their runtimes, then you can always opt out to leave the seasonal adjustment set at 100% for that particular program, and then make whatever adjustments you consider pertinent on your own. The ACC controller allows you to track the adjustments the solar sink is making so you can monitor its performance. You can review these adjustments by turning the dial to Data History and selecting Controller Log. When you access the controller logs, you will be able to see events such as seasonal adjustment changes, among others. Each log will show the date and time and the before and after percentage for the adjustments. Even if you manually change the seasonal adjustment percentage, the controller will also track that, but it will specify that the change was done at the controller level, not by means of solar sync. Note that the solar sync does not necessarily make an adjustment every single day. If weather conditions don't change, neither will the solar sync adjustment, and there will not be a log entry for those days. The ACC controller has the capacity to detect and log any changes made by the sensor. Within the Data History menu, you can choose to view the alarm log. If the rain or temperature sensors of the solar sink have been mapped to any of the four sensor inputs on the controller, and one of them detects an alarm condition, such as rain or freeze, the display will immediately show Attention Solar Sink Rain Alarm, or S-Sync Temp Alarm, even if the dial is pointed to run. Every alarm will be recorded in the alarm log with the time and day that the alarm occurred. So this concludes the process for installing and setting up a solar sink sensor on the ACC controller. We explained how the solar sink sensor interacts with an ACC controller, and we showed you how to check the master module and the face pack version for solar sync compatibility. We went over the process for connecting the solar sync sensor to the controller, as well as how to program the controller when a solar sync is going to be used. We went over the process for setting up the solar sync sensor, including enabling the solar sync in the controller, checking for proper communication, choosing the most appropriate region, and making future adjustments if necessary. We also showed you how to assign the rain and temperature functions of the solar sink to individual sensor inputs and how to configure them to react to rain or freezing conditions by program. Finally, we determined which programs will be controlled by solar sink and how we can view a history of the changes that the solar sink sensor has made. For more detailed information on the operation of your ACC controller, refer to the owner's manual. It can be found at hunterindustries.com.